हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संजय कोतवाल स्टार्टिंग द वीडियो। व्हाट इज द टाइम पीरियड ऑफ एंशिएंट हिस्ट्री? यू नो दैट हिस्ट्री इज डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री पोर्शंस, एंशिएंट हिस्ट्री, मिडवेल हिस्ट्री एंड मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री। इन सिक्स क्लास कोर्स इज एंशिएंट हिस्ट्री। द एंशिएंट हिस्ट्री टाइम पीरियड इज 2000 BCE to 647 AD after death of Christ. Okay, now what is the time period of Midway history? Midway history started from 647 AD after the death of Harshvardhan to 1707, the death of Aurangzeb. This time period is called of Midway history. The Midway history is also divided into two portions. First is early Midway period. This time period is 647 to 1206. It is also known as Rajput period. Now the second portion is later Midway period. This time period is 1206 AD to 1707 AD. Now listen, the sources of the information for the Midway history: epigraphic evidence, it is also known as inscriptions; numismatic evidence, it means numismatic is the study of coins; coins, archaeological evidence, buildings, sculptures, etc.; artistic evidence, painting, rock painting, etc.; literary evidence, it means books. Now what is inscription? Inscription is the writing on the hard surface, just like rock, metal and stone. We found so many inscriptions in that time period. What is epigraphy? Epigraphy is the study of inscription, is called epigraphy. Epigraphy is a very beautiful art to study the inscription. Now next topic is, what is prashasti? Prashasti, long poems in the honor of the king or in praise of the king, is called prashasti. Now what is numismatic? Numismatic means the study of the coins is called numismatic, because the early Midway period is also known as Rajput period. It is totally studied on the basis of coins and books. We are not known exactly in that period. It is also known as third dark age. In that dark age, no extra proofs are available. Now next, what is monuments and buildings? So many mosques and temples built during the Midway period, just like Qutub Minar, Taj Mahal, Red Fort, and so many temples, just like Jagannath Puri temple, Meenakshi temple, so many temples. And last topic, the paintings. We found so many paintings during that time, just like Elephanta Caves near the Bombay and the Ellora Caves also present in Maharashtra, Aurangabad district near the Ajanta Caves. How many types of literary evidence? There are two types of literary evidence we found. One is indigenous or local, or you say Indians. In that, Indian writers and Indian poets' books mentioned in that time period. Next is foreign sources. Foreign sources also divided into so many categories, just like European writers, Arab writers, Persian writers, Turk writers, Chinese writers, and so on. These books give lot of information about our country. In foreign writers, particularly Britishers, started in our country history written work. That name was Sir William Jones. He established Asiatic Society of Bengal in Calcutta city in 1780s. He started to translate the foreign books into the Indian languages and Indian languages book into the European languages books. I repeat, there are two types of the literary evidence. First is indigenous and second is foreign sources. Okay, that's all.